Robin Williams, Mayor Craig Jackson, and also available will be our members of our federal law enforcement partners. Mayor?
Well, we want to announce that there is an award of up to $50,000 for the arrest of Mr. Steve Stevens. The money comes from the FBI, ATF, and the Marshal Service. We also want to emphasize that we are still engaged in very aggressive and very focused attempt to find Steve Stevens and bring him to justice. We will emphasize again the need for the community to give us support. They've been very supportive as during this incident, and we ask for them to continue to be supportive of it. So I'll turn it over to the chief, who will give you some more details.
Thanks, Mayor. As the mayor stated, the new developments are the reward that's being offered, thanks to our federal partners and Crime Stoppers. We appreciate that. But also, we're still employing Steve to turn himself in, definitely to contact a relative or friend, because there are a lot of folks out there that want to talk to him, want to get this resolved peacefully. So, Steve, if you're out there listening, call someone, whether it's a friend or family member or a pastor, give them a call, because they're waiting on you to call them. We're a little over 24 hours away from when this incident started, and we definitely want to get it resolved as fast as possible. The victim's family, they deserve that, and the community deserves it. Our reach now is basically all over this country. Our federal partners, our local partners, have reached out to their contacts all over the country, and this is what we would consider a national search for Steve. So we are not going to leave any stone unturned. The tips, we want them to keep coming in, because we receive dozens and dozens of tips. The FBI line, please call that line if you have a tip out of the area. If you have something locally, call 911. Keep those tips coming in, and we do follow up on every tip we receive. The mayor has conversed with the family. This administration has talked to them. We know their hearts are heavy, and we're trying to get this resolved. So with that, if there are any questions, we'll open it up.
Chief, is there any reason to believe he's still in the vehicle that you suspect that he was driving at the beginning of all this?
Well, right now, we don't have any reason to believe that he's not in that vehicle. When these things start to evolve and people, maybe switch vehicles or things like that, he's not going to go out and buy a vehicle. So usually there is some kind of crime involved in securing a new vehicle. And we haven't had any reports like that so far.
Chief, is there any truth that he's been spotted in Philadelphia?
No, there's no truth to that. But again, we're receiving dozens and dozens of tips, and we follow up on all tips that we receive.
I
think we're all standing here because of what unfortunately happened to one of our citizens here in the city, minding his own business, going about his day on Easter. It is personal. Definitely.
Chief, what have you been able to, and I apologize if this question was asked this morning, what have you been able to determine happened with this woman that he mentioned in this video that might have led to this state line that he said yesterday?
To be honest, we've interviewed several people involved in this, and I don't think there's any rhyme or reason for it happening. I don't think there's anything that we can point to specifically to say that this is what sparked this. Only Steve knows that. Hopefully we can find him soon, and then we'll get to talk to him and find out exactly why he did this.
Have you been able to locate the people that he was talking to on his cell phone?
We've located a lot of people that he's been talking to, and they've been cooperative in the investigation so far.
How long was the post up on Facebook before it was taken down?
I can't give you an exact time frame, but it was something.
But was it up for minutes, hours? Can you say?
I couldn't tell you exactly. Chief, do you believe Stevens is still in the Cleveland area or that he has gone to another state?
We don't know. You know, when these things happen, there are a couple scenarios that play themselves out. You know, I don't want to speculate on any of those scenarios. Of course, we in law enforcement kind of look to all of them and, you know, govern the investigation according to, you know, things that have happened in the past and things that we think may happen in the future. But I can't tell you, you know, I can't tell you one way or another. We're trying to follow any investigative lead. We're trying to make sure that we in law enforcement, you know, kind of look in the past and really bring something to this case that's going to locate it. And all that's being done.
Is there any evidence, though, that he's outside of Ohio?
No.
Chief, what about the parents who are trying to deal with this, who have to talk to their children about this? What's the message you have to parents who need to talk to their children about it?
Well, our message to the community at large is to be careful. You know, unfortunately, we're in an era where things like this happen, maybe not to this degree, maybe not this publicly, as was done. But we have to be careful, we have to be vigilant, and we have to watch over each other.
Are you doing anything different for the game tonight, Chief?
Yeah, and just a further comment on your question, as the mayor says, you know, it's traumatizing to our community, to everybody, not just our kids. And, you know, the Division of Police, our law enforcement partners, you know, we have counselors available. We have counselors now in contact with the family. And if there is a need out there, whether it be at a school or an institution, we can arrange for counselors to come out and talk to folks.
Chief, can you comment on the search of the home in Twinsburg and the weapons that were recovered? Were they his?
I can't give you an exact synopsis of all that, but we've searched every available location where he's either resided, where he's had family members, and they've cooperated in those searches, and there have been items recovered, yes.
Were they weapons? Were they guns?
Some were weapons, some were other things that are pertinent to the investigation.
And they were his? Can you comment on how they
I can't it? Verify who they belonged.
Are you still assuming he's armed?
Yes. Yes, we definitely, I think we can say without a doubt, he's armed.
You know what the murder weapon was, specifically?
It was a pistol. I can't give you the caliber and things like that, but yes, he's armed.
Chief,
you
should be releasing
them.
Chief, did you all find any video or pictures of his car from the highway cameras, any of the cameras that they have caught that?
We've been looking at video throughout the area. I don't know specifically, and our investigators would have to talk to that. If we specifically found that vehicle within a video, but I mean a white, you know, newer model vehicle, there are thousands out there.
Right, how hard is it to try to pinpoint?
It's very hard. It's difficult to, I mean, again, you know, it's a white 2016 vehicle, four-door, and there are thousands that travel throughout Northeast Ohio.
Do you think
the
OBU
would
see 911
tapes? Those get processed through public records, so we'll get that too.
Yeah, we'll get the tapes out, but we really want to concentrate on finding Steve and bringing closure to this family.
Chief, people talk about people snapping and doing something so spontaneous. Is there anything that you can talk about that led up? Did he have financial problems? Anything in his past?
Again, there are a lot of things that go on in people's lives, and we at this point cannot concentrate on one issue that may or may not have led to this. I mean, there are a lot of things going on in his life, I'm sure. As evident by what's happening, but we're not going to pinpoint a specific thing and say that's what triggered this. Because we don't know. And when we talk to him, we'll be able to find out more about it.
Thank you for coming. We'll provide more updates as it comes appropriate for this information.
Thank you.
Can you tell us anything about what gave rise to the activity in Philadelphia?
Again, we're following up on every lead that comes in to us, every single lead.
So something came in from that area?
From that area, yes. And continue this in those leads.